just a few minutes away from the state Class B championship game in Aberdeen at the Barnett Center. Gary Ellenbolt, John Sieber alongside. We're set to bring you basketball, the title game coming up in about 10 or 12 minutes. Let's take a look at both teams. The visitors on your TV tonight or on your computer screen, the Vibert Hurley Cougars, combining the two schools, the Vibert Vikings and the Hurley Bulldogs. And they will wear both teams' colors, actually, black, white, red, and orange. Vibert Hurley has had a long and twisty road over the last few years as a co-op program. In 2009, Vibert taking fifth place in the State B tournament, losing to Sully Buttes, 65-62 was that score. In 2010, a third-place effort in B, losing to White River in the semifinals, 65-59 was that final score. And in 2011, Vibert Hurley, the Cougars, moved up to Class A. They lost in the championship game out in Rapid City. St. Thomas More, the winner of its first state championship at the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. St. Thomas More going for a championship tonight in Class A, as they'll be taking on Dakota Valley, the Panthers, and the Cavaliers in Sioux Falls in just a matter of minutes. Zach Freening has really driven the boat most of the way for Vibert Hurley, but he injured his ACL and his MCL in the course of the regular season. He will have surgery after the season on those ligaments, but for now, he is in. He has had a very quiet tournament, just 2 points in the win. Needed every point as they got the win by 1 point, 37-36 over Langford last night. Craning, a 6'9 senior, provides some size, but he obviously is having some trouble moving for the Vibert Hurley squad. His supporting cast, Dennis Dedai, has had an awesome tournament, 28 points over two games, shooting 52% from the field for the state tournament. Andrew Hora, Jack Huther, and Trevor Jacobson, the other starters for the Vibert Hurley squad, which beat Woolsey Wessington first-round game 48-27. That was the last game on Thursday night, and then in the last game on Friday night, Vibert Hurley winning again, beating Langford area, and again just by 1 point, 37-36. A look at the number one seed, the White River Tigers, coming up on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Activities Association Championship is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, by Dakota Bank, and by Farmers Union Insurance.
He's John Sieber and Gary Lindholm. We're back live at the Barnett Center in Aberdeen. Just a few seats remaining for their State Class B championship game. The home team, the number one seed, 24-1 White River. You see some of the Tiger fans getting ready for basketball in just a few minutes here in Aberdeen. Wyatt Krogman is a guy who makes a lot of noise, and a lot of that has to do with the name, certainly, but it's not just an all Krogman show. Comes from a very long bloodline, but you've got Nick Wan to worry about. Gilbert Morrison has had a very good tournament. Matt Gillen and Logan Tucker providing some of the size inside for the Tigers. And there is the starting lineup. If you're a Class B boys coach in South Dakota and you weren't nervous already, get nervous now. You've got four juniors at the starting lineup for a team that's 24-1 right now. Krogman is back. Gillen, Wand, and Morrison. Logan Tucker, the only senior playing his last game at White River. He, a 6'5 senior. They're used to the pressure. Of course, Vibert Hurley is too. White River coming up with a second place finish in the state at 2011 as they lost to Corsica Stickney in the state championship game a year ago. Here on the Barnett Center floor. They beat Castlewood and Sully Buttes to earn their way to the state tournament final game. Castlewood going down 54-33. Sully Buttes was a winner 61-34. Along the tournament trail, the Tigers beating Kadoka area, Jones County, and Wall to reach the state tournament. State championship basketball coming up from the Barnett Center after this on member-supported South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
It's almost time to get the State B championship game underway. This will be the fifth consecutive year that White River has played in this championship game, winning it all in 08 and 2010. taking second place last year and also in 09. We'll have the call of the game for you coming up in just a few minutes here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Right now, to get the starting lineups, let's go to our PA announcer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The City of Aberdeen, Northern State University, and Aberdeen Central High School, along with the South Dakota High School Activities Association, welcomes you to the 2012 State B Championship Game. The designated visitors tonight will be the Viburg Hurley Cougars, and the home team will be the White River Tigers. Let's meet tonight's participants. First, the cheerleaders of Viburg Hurley, Kimberly Kolthoff, Michelle Miller, Lacadia Christensen, Laura Evison, Rosalind Rasmussen, Kayla Anderson, Caitlin Graber, and Megan Knock. The Cougars cheer coach is Becky Roth. Now the cheerleaders for White River, Cassandra Artichoker, Tierra Oxdahl, Etta Castaway, Macy Gillen, Georgianne Larvey, and Jesse Roundsley. The White River cheer coach is Kayla Brown. And now the starters in alternating fashion. First for the Cougars, a 6'1" senior, number 15, Dennis Denai. And for the Tigers, 5'11" junior, number 10, Gilbert Morrison. And a guard for the Cougars, 5'11" sophomore, number 22, Jack Huther. And for the Tigers, 5'9" junior, number 23, Nick Wan. And a guard for the Cougars, 5'9" junior, number 23, Trevor Jacobson. And for the Tigers, 5'10" junior, number 30, Wyatt Krogman. And a wing for the Cougars, 6'5" junior, number 30, Andrew Hora. And for the Tigers, 6'5" senior, number 44, Logan Tucker. In the middle for Viburg Hurley, the 6'9" senior, number 32, Zach Craning. And for White River, 6'2" junior, number 45, Matt Gillen. The Cougars are coached by Tony Hauger and Justin Oswald. Head coach for Viburg Hurley is Galen Schoenfeld. The Tigers are coached by Jared Bauman. Head coach for White River is Mr. Eldon Marshall. Tonight's officials are Tom Waggy, Mark Logan, and Brett Sether.
Thirty-two minutes to decide the 2011-2012 State B Boys Basketball Champion in South Dakota. Who will it be, White River or Viburg Hurley? With the call, the man who has more useless information than anybody else I know, Gary Ellenbolts.
Appreciate it, John. Hi, everybody. My honor to call this championship game for you tonight from the Barnett Center. Logan Tucker set to jump center against Zach Craning. The ball in the air. Hope you enjoy the game and this state championship broadcast. And thank you for your support, making it possible on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. White River looking to draw first blood. They get the first possession, and Wyatt Krogman hands the ball for the Tigers. Viburg Hurley setting up, showing man-to-man, going right side. Juan is there. He has had a very good tournament. Krogman to the top of the circle. Switch the hands on the dribble, work toward the right side. Crating out of it a bit, tries the three-pointer. It's off the side of the backboard, and no good. Actually, just to the side of the rim. He missed it at any rate, and here's Huther down the floor for Viburg Hurley. Shot is up, no good. Well, it fell, but it's going to be an offensive foul. Player control variety, Huther gets his first.
Wyatt Krogman saw him coming from the get-go on that one, and Krogman slid down to the spot where he was going to, where they were going to intersect, and just stood there and waited on him. And Huther did not elect to pull up for the jump shot, instead tried to power it over him. And the first foul of the game goes on Viburg Hurley.
Jack Huther with the personal foul, number 22 with one, first of the game. And here comes Morrison, hit shot for three, is off the front of the rim and no good. Training pinballs rebound. It's going to go to Hora. Now on the right side, Huther again. He'll set it up, get it to Denai. Denai has had just a great tournament. Trevor Jacobson, the basketball now for Viber Curley. Cougars nothing, Tigers nothing. Ball taken away. Logan Tucker coming up with the steal. Perfect timing to get in front of the Viber Curley offense to get the ball.
Well, that time Tucker undercut the pass and stepped in front of Craning.
Juan loses the ball, goes off the body of Hora for Viber Curley.
Something to watch for in this, in the early going in the game here, Gary. And so far, the first two possessions have Viber Curley's been going underneath the screens. The watch White River, they set the ball screen for Wyatt Krogman. Here comes the ball screen from Tucker up top. Now Krogman waves him off. He sees what they're doing. They're undercutting the screen and forcing Krogman to take the outside jumper instead of letting him get in the lane. And there he is in the
Krogman
lane.
Krogman in the driveway inside. Good to foul.
That's what happens when you let him get in the paint.
One of the very first things I heard from Brian White, the head coach at Sully Buttes, I asked him, what are your thoughts, what are your concerns about the White River team? He said, we've got to keep Krogman from getting in the lane.
Well, it's easier said than done. They tried it with ball screens the first couple of possessions, and Viber Curley undercut the ball screen and forced him back outside. They did kind of a hedge. You had the person who was his man was screening, setting the screens, kind of hedged out and forced him to go back. But that time, Krogman waved off the screen. Heady ball player waved off the screen, said, no, let me do it myself.
Paul, foul on Jack Huther. Huther is going to pick up foul number two. He's out of the game. Tyler Gertis checks in. Ball is knocked loose. Here comes White River. Krogman loses the ball off his foot. It is going to go to Viber Curley. And Krogman never really had control of the dribble almost from the time he crossed the center line.
Didn't have control of it, but it was a great steal on the other end for White River. And they're back to that man-to-man, in-your-face defense we saw him play last night that just kind of totally took Sully Buttes out of their offense.
Denai on the drive. Dishes off left side. Craning puts it up. Craning's got it. He has had an extremely quiet tournament. There's his first points of the game. One on the other end. Shots up. Shots good. Frank meet time for White River.
You cannot take time to congratulate yourself on a made shot on the other end because White River's going to beat you down court.
Exactly what happened there. Juan with the feed. Put it up, put it down. Jacobson shoots. It's good.
Nice.
Oh, is that the night it's going to be? 5-4 is the score.
Jacobson right down the lane, and nobody came over to help out Juan. Once he got beat, that's all she wrote.
Nick Juan, the ball right sideline extended. Gilbert Morrison, good three-point shooter. Won't take it there. Get it off to Krogman. Krogman, the right-hand dribble. Wants room on the driveway. Not going to let him inside. It'll get on the top for just a second. That was Matt Gillen in the high post. Juan dribbles left hand, switches the hands, looks right side. Krogman trying to break free, and the ball's kicked, and we have stopped action. And White River should get it back.
We'll go over to White River on the kick ball. White River won their first state championship, 1955.
I was not around.
I did not call that game, no.
All right. Tigers basketball, Tigers lead by one at 5-4. Krogman sets it down low. Here with the shot, it's on the way. It's off the side of the rim and no good. Gillen tried it, and with the rebound, Andrew Hora flying down the floor for the Viber Curley Cougars. On the right side, Gertis sets up for Craning. It's out of bounds.
Off Morrison.
And the call is going to give it back to Viber Curley. Denai will do the inbound. 4:49, first period, 5-4, White River. Denai looks to inbound, finds somebody there. That's going to be Jacobson. Gertis on the top left of the circle, looking toward the right side, finds some room on the driveway. Shot is up and good. They just gave him the lane, and Gertis put it up and hit.
Second time here early going that nobody has helped out on defense once the initial defender was beaten off the dribble.
Gillen for Krogman, kicks out on top. Logan Tucker lost it into the hands of Gertis momentarily. Now it's back into the hands of White River, and they get it right back.
And it was Denai, his own teammate, that knocked the ball away from Gertis.
Here is Krogman, left side. Morrison's there on the top for Juan. Thinks three, stops and fires the 15. It's good.
Nice touch from Juan. Caught enough of the rim to curl it in.
Nick Juan, an outstanding basketball player. You don't hear a lot of him because, and rightfully, you hear a lot about Wyatt Krogman. But Juan, very quietly, has an outstanding performance night in, night out. Training left side, seven-footer good.
Well, Tucker did all he could on that one. Went high for the try to try to steal the pass, couldn't do it. And Craning, that little five-footer off the glass, that's his shot right there.
New play called out by Eldon Marshall. Wyatt Krogman relays it to the rest of the Tigers in the home whites with the purple and gold numbers, trim, etc. Number one seed in the tournament, they've worn the home whites the whole way on the top of the bracket. Viber Hurley in the black, white, red, and orange. Here's Juan right side through the lane. Looks for help on top. Going to be Krogman. He starts the slow dribble with the right hand. Swatted away for a second by Hora. Wyatt gets it back. Down low they come. Gillen shot. Rejected. Out of bounds. And no foul.
Well, that's the size of Viber Hurley. They'll take Craning out now, but they'll replace him with 6'5", Ryan Klute.
And Ryan Klute has had a really nice tournament as well, John.
They're going a little smaller now as they take out Klute and also Hora.
Gillen gets it up. Not a problem for Craning to swat that away, as you just saw. And the Tigers have the ball back. 3:10 to go in the first. 8-7 the score. Whistle foul. That will go on Viber Hurley. Galen Schoenfeld wanting a travel call in the worst way. Doesn't get his wish. The foul is going to go on Gertis for Viber Hurley.
We'll see how long they keep Hora and Craning out of the ball game here. Craning about this time of the game has been coming out all tournament.
Wyatt missed the first free throw. Krogman will get another.
Considerably smaller now as they've got Gertis trying to stay with Cody Young, who's checked into the ball game. Cody Young is 6'5", senior, big bulky kid. I don't think Gertis is going to have too much success trying to guard Young, especially with Gertis in there at, what is he, 5'10"?
Krogman ties the game up, 8-8, 4 points for Krogman. Half of the scoring output coming from number 30, Wyatt Krogman for the White River Tigers. Top left side of the circle is Gertis. Works toward the left side, nothing there. On top, denies, saves the errant pass. Nice job on the catch. Denied to the right, has Jacobson there, finds him on the high right. 2:45 to go in period number one. They get it off to Gertis. It's swatted out of bounds, and Viber Hurley's going to keep it.
Well, when Gertis flashed to the elbow, he thought Denayet was going to run the baseline and just turn and threw it right to the baseline, and nothing there.
Dennis Denayet will take care of the inbound for Viber Hurley, or he'd better. Right side it comes to Gertis. Jacobson wide open, three ball on the way. In, out, no good. Rebound is going to come up, and a foul. Foul is going to send Matt Jensen to the free throw line. White River gets its first of the night. That's on Wyatt Krogman.
Well, you got Joe Cameron, 6'2 junior, in the ball game for White River. When you look at that 6'2, 6'4, 6'4, 6'2 in the lane, who gets the rebound? 5'9, senior Matt Jensen.
Jensen hits the first free throw. He'll get another. Cougars retake the lead. It's 9-8. There's the shot. There is Jensen trying the putback. Krogman all over him with the foul. Second shot off the front of the rim and barely. It will come into the hands of White River as Gillen got the rebound.
And we saw Krogman get in foul trouble yesterday. He had to set for a lot of the first half.
Cody Young puts the shot up. It's no good. Got that off the side of the rim. Nice effort he had over Ryan Klute, but not able to connect on the shot. Viber Hurley brings it the other way. Cougars 9, Tigers 8, 2:11 to go. Gertis the ball, left sideline extended. Wants to come up top, does so. That is going to be Jensen with the basketball. Jacobson just about lost it. Trevor able to hang on. Stops from A-man corner. Bounce pass down low. Here's the shot. Oh, has it rejected. Oh, Margaret, what a block by Gillen. White River down the floor in a hurry. Krogman sets up the offense for the top of the circle. Coming left side, left-hand dribble. Jacobson on him is on the defense. Setting up down low. Cody Young for five. Good.
Too easy for Young. Too easy for Young. If Viber Hurley has a chance in this game, they're going to have to get a bigger body on Cody Young. Cody Young has just been tearing people up here at this tournament.
Craning will check back in just a couple of minutes here. As soon as there's a dead ball, minute and 28 in the first. Wants to set up left side. Jensen is there. Jensen double team. Bounce pass denied. Deny without a point here. He's at 28 for the tournament. Here's the drive of the shot. No good. Gets it up. Puts it back. Fouled. And no foul.
And the foul, I think, is going to be on Gillen.
Bounced a couple of times off the top of the rim. Gillen will pick up the personal foul. That'll be his first, just the second on White River. Craning is in. Hora checks in. Sitting down will be Gertis and Ryan Klute. Inbounding is denied. Minute 16 to go. 10-9 lead for White River. Craning's got it way out between the rings. He will not take the shot there. Denai won't either. On the top of the wheel for Jacobson. Aim in corner. They go to Matt Jensen. Wants the baseline whistle. Traveling violation. The call on Viper, Hurley, and Jensen. And White River brings it the other way.
Let's watch this matchup on the offensive end. Cody Young and Craning. They got Zach Craning guarding Young now. Here's this ball screen.
Comes out in the high post. Here's the shot on the way. Krogman misses. Ball pinballed around. Young gets it back. Shots on the way. Rejected. He's going to get the ball back again after the Craning block. Shot for the third time on the way. And no opportunity to get a fourth because it goes off the rim. And Matt Jensen picks up the rebound. All 5-9 with the board for Vibert Hurley.
What an effort by Cody Young to keep that ball alive.
Craning blocked it right back into his hands, not able to get the shot off a third time. Foul is going to go on Cody Young as Gerdes was trying to drive on the baseline. That'll be foul number three for White River. There have been three fouls also on Viber Hurley. And Jack Huther coming back in.
Huther back in. I was going to say Huther back in. They're going to get Jensen out of the ballgame, or Jacobson now will take a breather here.
Viber Hurley wants the timeout. Finally, it's called and acknowledged. Caleb Schoenfeld calling the short timeout with 35.1 seconds to go. Setting up some strategy, probably for one shot here. 10-9, White River has the lead over Viber Hurley in this first period game.
I'm sorry, was I supposed to keep track of the other games going on?
One of us can, doesn't matter. There was the shot on the end from Cody Young. Made it a 10-9 ball game. We have the eighth third place game that is done. Del Rapids has won that. Championship game is St. Thomas More out of Rapid City against Dakota Valley. That from the McCook Lake Jefferson area in the southeastern corner of the state. Pierre leading Sioux Falls, Washington in the third. That's the AA third place game, 47-45 there.
Well, and if Tri-Valley was pretty much a home game for those guys in the state tournament, and Del Rapids in that semifinal or in that third place game, Dakota Valley just down the road is going to be about the same thing.
St. Thomas More from the other side of the state, but the defending A champions. Last year in the final, they beat the team playing here in the B tournament. That is Viber Hurley.
And we are into the second quarter at the state A, and it's 13-13.
Traveling violation, the call and deny. Denying that he traveled. Doesn't say a lot, just gives up the ball and has a look on his face like, what in the world was that about?
Well, they had their ball handler. They had to take Jacobson out because when you're trying to chase Wyatt Krogman, when you're going to expend a lot of energy on the defensive side of things. And now they switched Jacobson over to one.
12 seconds to go. Tigers had the ball. I'm sorry, Jim. Go ahead.
And they brought Jensen over to guard Krogman.
8 seconds, 7 seconds. Tigers will work for one. Here comes Krogman getting a move on. Left side, here's the shot. Cameron puts up the three up the back of the rim. And that's how the first period will end.
Wow.
10-9, this game as advertised. White River leads back in a minute on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Ten to nine score, White River leading Viber Hurley. In a very loud Barnett Center in Aberdeen, South Dakota, the final game, the championship contest of the South Dakota Class B Boys Basketball Tournament. Ball is knocked out of bounds. Cameron doing a nice job, trying to knock it out right side. Viber Hurley is going to get it back.
Little miscommunication there between Jacobson and Gerdes.
Tavis Burbank into the game for the first time now for White River. Craning down low, swatted away by Krogman. If that wasn't fascinating. Wyatt got it there, and I don't think Pat Craning, or not Pat Craning, that's the dad. Zach Craning didn't see or hear him coming. There's the shot on the way, foul. Denai will pick up the personal foul as Juan was trying to set up right side, and a pretty obvious foul.
Well, pretty obvious, but also a miscommunication on the defense. That's on the offense now. Viber Hurley just had a miscommunication. Now on the defensive end, because Juan was wide open, nobody was guarding him. Craning went out after him, and Juan gave him a little head fake and went around him, and with Denai covering up the box, had nothing, no other choice but to foul him.
Dennis Denai with his first personal foul. There comes Morrison, and there it was as he went up with the ball.
Well, you couldn't really see it in that shot there. He swatted with the left hand, but pushed him in the back with the right hand.
Both free throws successful. 12-9 is the score. Viber Hurley now down three. Nick Juan, 19 points in the win over Sully Buttes yesterday. Very good, very complete basketball player for Eldon Marshall's White River squad. Left side, here's Gerdes on the drive. Left side to Craning on the baseline, good.
Well, that's White River still giving up the middle of that lane, and for Vibert Hurley, they're going to have to pick on that all night. When defense does rotate over, they got to dish it off to one of the big guys down low.
12-11 White River. Krogman, three ball on the way. It's off the back of the rim and no good. Bodies akimbo as the ball goes out of bounds. Have a foul on the hold, and that is going on Tony Young. Hold the bus, Vibert.
It's going on
Vibert Hurley.
It's going on Hora.
All right, Hora instead of Young. They were both on the floor, and the foul on the hold going on Andrew Hora. That's going to be number one.
Hora and Burbank got tangled up. They took Cody Young. Cody Young was kind of collateral damage to that collision.
White River inbounding. High and dry, it's Krogman. Left side, Tavis Burbank on the line extended. Coming back now, Wyatt Krogman wants to come left side. Bounce pass down low. Here's Burbank at the baseline. Spins out of trouble. Go to the right side for one. And the driveway shot from 10. Deflected and a foul. Foul is going to go on Vibert Hurley once again. And this foul is on Craning. Last guy in the world, Galen Schoenfeld, wants in foul trouble. He's not right now. It's his first, but they all count. At the line is Juan. First is good.
Well, and what it does is it puts Juan on the free throw line. You got an 86% free throw shooter at the charity stripe. Odds are he's going to knock down everything that he hits.
Second one on the way.
Everything he puts up.
And he hit both of those.
Four out of four at the line here early going. Jacobson on the run out.
Here he comes on the fly in the driveway. Shots up, no good. He's fouled. He's going to get two. That foul is going to go on Logan Tucker, who got part of the body going after the block.
White River fans wanting a charge, no charge. Watch on the replay here, and you'll see Tucker was leaning back a little bit before the contact. Right there he goes.
There
he's
was.
Already beginning to lean back. Anticipating the contact, he leaned just a split second too soon.
Trevor Jacobson's first free throw is good. It's 14-12 now.
Jacobson 75% at the charity stripe.
5 points in the win over Langford area. That was a 37-36 game last night. Paul Roche is going to wonder for a while what might have been.
Well, and through the first quarter, Gary, Vibert Hurley shooting 5 of 8 for 62%. White River 4 of 14 for 28%.
Three quarters in the books in the AA third place game. Pierre by 4 over Sioux Falls, Washington. That's 57-53.
About 3 minutes to go before halftime at the A final, 20-19, St. Thomas More.
Tigers basketball, White River's lead at 14-12. Krogman on top, heads to the right side, Wanda Krogman. On the left side is Gilbert Morrison working toward the corner, stop at the baseline. Ball is taken away, and a beautiful steal that time by Tyler Gerdes of Vibert Hurley.
Gerdes read the eyes of Morrison. Once he got to the baseline, was shut off there. He had to pass back out. Gerdes reading the eyes and stepping in front of the pass.
Baseline left to Jacobson. Top of the circle, it comes to Hora, high post. Right side, they'll come. Gerdes, he is double teamed. Ball is almost stripped away, it's loose. Fans want the foul on the Vibert Hurley end. They're not only not gonna get the foul, they're gonna lose the basketball as it comes to White River.
Well, as Gerdes tried ripping through, the ball came flying out and went between the legs of his teammate out of bounds.
Gillen replaces Tavis Burbank for White River. 6:03 first half. It's a 14-12 lead for the White River Tigers. Just like a couple of prize fighters going at it here, exchanging punches.
Two players have scored for White River. Krogman with 4 and Juan with 8.
There's Morrison's shot from 10. That's off the back of the rim. Craning lost it. It still goes into the hands of White River, and here's Denai on the break. Denai bumping the bodies down the lane. Shots up. Good.
What a drive by Denai. Behind the back at two separate occasions and split the defenders and laid it in.
Denai wouldn't be. It's 14-14. 5:27, second period. White River and Vibert Hurley all knotted up. This is the only state tournament without an overtime of the entire weekend. Thought for a second we'd have one in the third place game. Langford area pulled it out. Shots on the way for Gillen. It's up and good.
Nice move by Gillen. Used the rim as an extra to kind of shield off Craning there a bit. But he took that extra dribble, Gary, and came from the left, the right block all the way over to the left block and scooped it up underhand. Gave Craning no chance at the block.
Denai's got the ball top of the circle. Krogman picks him up on the defense. Andrew Hora on the right side, line extended. Along the wing they come. Here's Denai, bumps the bodies.
Locking.
Whistle, foul on the block. It goes on White River. Getting up off the pile is Wyatt Krogman. That'll be his second foul.
Well, Denai is 6'1", 6'2". Krogman, they have him listed at 5'10". I don't think he's 5'10". I think he's a little shorter than that.
Barry backs down, and the feet obviously moving on Wyatt Krogman. That is going to be a block every time.
And if White River stays man-to-man, which I think they probably will, you'll see Viber Gurley posting up Denai a little more here.
Hora left side, shot is up on the way, and good. He had bodies all over him, but he's able to get the shot up and down. It's 16-16. More punches traded between the two. Cameron has the ball left side. He had just a great first game with 16 points in their first round win over Castlewood. Cameron the ball left side, line extended into Amen corner. They headed for one. Bounce pass will come low. Gillen against training turns, fires, no. Puts it up and goes off the back of Logan Tucker. It's out of bounds. Cougars have the ball.
Well, this game is not going to be for the faint-hearted. If you don't want to be in that middle, if you don't like the contact, you better not step inside the paint. And the last couple of possessions, Viber Gurley's gone 2-3 zone. Kind of mixing it up on defense for Coach Schoenfeld.
Jacobson around the right side. Wanted to get it to Denai. Ball loose on the floor. Jacobson with the save. Over to Dennis Denai. He tries to go on the left side. Goes off the hand of Hora out of bounds. White River hands it back. Denai probably had the shot there, but decided to get the higher percentage shot. Had Hora there. The pass was just a whizzer down the lane, and Hora not able to hang on.
Changed his mind way too late on making the pass. You're right, Gary. He should have taken the shot. Hora thought he was taking the shot, and when he elected to make the pass, just way too hard a pass in that situation.
White River wants to get the lead back. Gillen thought about it. They'll come left side. Here's Cameron. One to Wyatt. Wyatt out on top on the high right. Get it off on the high post for a second. That was Gillen. Here's Wyatt Krogman on the drive. Nothing doing there.
Hand
foul
check
on the push is going on Hora. Okay, Jacobson's going to pick up the foul. It's not going to be on Hora. I think Hora covered Jacobson, and I just didn't see him there. But Trevor Jacobson will pick up the personal foul. White River now in the bonus. A couple of fouls to give for the White River Tigers. They've just committed five. Krogman's first is good. I didn't think that wanted to drop. And finally, got the Krogman roll.
Kind of willed it in there.
Manny looks like every other Krogman walking the planet now, doesn't he? Spitting image of Big Brother Louie, who just wrapped up his career at the University of South Dakota and had just an incredible career as a USD Coyote. I can't believe that's done. 4 years already. Dave Boots is going to miss that guy. Ball top of the circle. Denai is there. He has 2 points, but he's been quiet, basically. Good ball handler. Trying to drive the driveway. Stops and fires. 14-footer. Goes 12. Ball goes out of bounds. It was last kicked by one of the Tigers. I think that was Cameron. Viber Hurley will keep it.
Well, and Ryan Klute reaching around was able to slap at the ball and knock it off the leg of the White River player.
Jacobson stops, wants to come down low. Got a foul on the reach. That is going to go on Cody Young.
That's Young's second foul. That time didn't get around Klute fast enough. And right now, the foul situation beginning to add up. 7 fouls on Viber Hurley. That is the 6th on White River.
White River hasn't had a lot of foul trouble throughout this tournament. They played a very clean, hard basketball game without a lot of fouls committed. Here's the shot on the way. He couldn't get it done. Could Matt Jensen. It's out of bounds. Oh. And I think we're coming the other way as Gertis checks in. He will replace Denai. Viber Hurley is going to keep the ball. And coming out of the game, Dennis Denai. He has been a good floor leader through the game. Hasn't shown much in the way of points, but has handled the ball very well. Cougars basketball. It's 18-16. Shot down low. It's good. Give it to Hora.
Credit the patience that time of Klute for taking the ball out. He waited, didn't take his first option, his second option, and right there was Hora popping open.
Krogman right side, Gillen up and good.
Well, that's what happens when Krogman gets in the lane. You have to send everybody after him, and when you do, somebody's going to be open.
And Gillen was right there, put up the easy shot. Gillen for the game now with 4 points. It is 20-18, White River. Jacobson right side, on the line extended to the right. That for just a second was Ryan Klute. Come to the right, Jacobson once again. He dribbles out of the wing, out of trouble. Tries to get it to Gertis. Gertis almost lost it. He got it back. White River showing zone once again. Looking on the down low. Nope, man-to-man defense. Okay. Look for a zone, like a zone for a split second, but they were going man. And for their trouble, Cameron comes up with the steal. Krogman on top. On the left side, Cody Young backs down, drives, misses. He's fouled.
And Klute, as soon as Young took that little drop step, we've seen him do that all tournament, take that drop step to that baseline. He is left-handed. We took the drop step. Klute kind of put an arm, a little forearm in his ribs and kind of helped him along the way, put him way behind the backboard.
Young's first free throw is up. No, spins out, wouldn't go.
And Young shooting about 63% from the charity stripe. Going to get Craning back in here for the last 2:06. Both coaches, Gary, doing a really nice job of substituting and getting some fresh players in there and giving everybody a rest.
You can really see the chess match between Eldon Marshall and Galen Schoenfeld, can't you? Second for Young is good. Makes that 21-18, 2:05 to go. Pier by one, third place game, State AA. 5:15 of the fourth at 64-63, Governors over Sioux Falls, Washington. Right side is Andrew Hora. Wants to get it to somebody. Threw it away. Well over the head of Jacobson. Into the hands of Eldon Marshall, who's not eligible. White River is going to get the basketball back.
And of course, Eldon, being the veteran coach he is, hangs on to the ball. Make sure that Tom Waggy knows that he's got to watch those elbows out there.
3-point lead for White River. Tigers ball, high post, they go to Young.
I'll give you the ball back, but you got to listen to me first.
Krogman right side. Shot is on the way from 16. That's off the back of the rim. Cody Young gets the board. White River gets to regroup. Cameron on top for Krogman. Whatever the spin play is, that's what Eldon Marshall just called. And here comes a little bit of motion. Young on the top of the circle. Left side for Krogman. Wyatt on the drive. Quick pass to Juan on the right. Shot for three. Fire in the hole! First three-pointer of the ball game as Juan goes right side, fires and hits. With a minute 16 left, Tigers opening it up just a bit. I think Galen Schoenfeld and the Cougars should be kind of glad halftime's coming up. That'll give them a chance to regroup. There's the deep three by Juan. Forced it up with every bit of his body behind it.
All started with the dribble penetration by Krogman. That's what teams try to do, is keep Krogman out of the paint. If you're successful, you usually beat White River.
Jacobson right side. Denai is on the high right. Morrison's on him. Ball is taken away. Here comes Gillen. Got one guy to beat on the drive. Shots up good.
And now White River, 7-0 run. They're out to eight-point lead. I don't know if you can get down by more than this. Nice flurry by White River here to end the half, Gary.
They have shown so many weapons tonight, and that was just a beautiful play by Gillen that time, too. He got the steal, flies down the court, had one guy to beat. Hora did everything he could. And here is that steal. Here's Gillen. You see Horan come up behind him, finally catches up. By that time, Gillen was able to take the shot, and he got it up and down. Several awards coming up, the Spirit of Six, the Spirit of Sioux, and more at halftime here, which is coming up at 59.1 seconds. Galen Schoenfeld calling the timeout. He's got to settle the team down, and basically what he has to tell them is keep an eye on Krogman, and whatever you do, don't let him in the lane, because that's how Vibert Hurley keeps getting burned tonight.
Well, that's just it, and White River's cranked up that defense. They've stepped up the defensive intensity. And so far, Viber Gurley has not reacted very well to the defensive intensity that White River's brought here in the last minute and a half.
59.1 seconds to go. White River has the 8-point lead over Viber Gurley. This is the Tigers' biggest lead tonight. It's 26-18. Jacobson over the Seiko stripe. Down low, Denai trying to go baseline. He's fouled on the way up. And Dennis Denai is going to the line for two.
We'll see what they call a foul on. It's going to be on Cameron. I don't think the issue was the block, Gary. You can see the block clean right here. The issue was the body right there.
There it was. Got him right in the chest, right between the 1 and the 5 on the Cougar jersey. First for Denai is good.
The block up top was clean, all ball with the hand, but the body was the story. And the fans, when they're watching, all they're watching is the ball. They're not watching the body side of things, which is what the officials do. It's from the process. It's start to finish.
Pretty good midair collision there, too. Second shot for Denai. Nothing to it. 26-20. White River leading by six, 48 seconds until halftime.
I don't know if Weiberg-Hurley can get down by 10 points, if they can come back on White River if they get down by more than 10. They have to keep it close here. And looks like White River's going to hold for one.
And the consideration they have, you know, Zach Craning is still hobbling. He still has the ACL tear. He's still wearing two braces on the leg, which has to slow him down considerably. And Krogman has had a couple of good opportunities in the free throw lane. He has either scored or has passed off to people who've been able to score, like the Juan three-pointer, like the Gillen layup down low. Now they work the motion. 9 seconds, 8 seconds to go. Krogman comes left side, comes off the screen, wants the driveway. Left side, Gillen got it. Run to perfection by White River, and the first half is over. And the Class B state championship game, 28-20, is the score. And we'll be back with our awards presentation after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
This evening, on behalf of the SDHSAA Activities Board, our director members, Gene Brownell. Assisting with the awards and representing the association's corporate partners are Gordon Larson of Sanford Health and Christy Osterloo of First Premier Bank Premier Bank Card, Terry Lindy of Farmers Union Insurance, and Sergeant First Class Aaron Wahlberg of the South Dakota Army National Guard. This year's fourth place team were the Chargers of Sully Buttes, Scott Sefter, Herman Kleinsasser, Jordan Lamb, Connor Euler, Connor Archer, Cody Nelson, Braden Whitler, Caleb Currier, Willie Coulson, Josh Lamb, Lewis Hofer, Reed Feller, Bram Printner, Adam Brocky, and Jalen Lamb. Statisticians were Carly Yost and Cordell Ring. Assistant coach Randy Poole. And the head coach for the Sully Buttes Chargers, Brian White. The Sully Buttes Welcome Home will take place at the Ramcota Conference Room after tonight's championship game. And now for our 2012 third place team, the Langford Lions. Dalton Lone. Weston Hoagland, Dante Blanchard, Bo Fries, Nick Alberts, Tyler Block, Kyle Johnson, Brian Anderson, Drew Plantine, Michael Erickson, Zach Punt, Chase Larson, Tyler Blanchard, Brent Ogren, Kyle Amundsen, and Brady Hoynes. Statisticians, Jesse Carson, Carter Ewalt, and Zach Fries. Managers, Mason Larson, Logan Block, and Alex Steiner. Assistant coaches, Roy Pulfrey, and Monty Peterson. Head coach for the Langford Lions, Paul Roche. The Langford Welcome Home will take place at the gym tomorrow at 1 o'clock. We would now like to direct your attention to the area in front of the band. Today's tournament band, playing for all the sessions today, was the Ross Holt High School Band under the direction of Buffy Chemnitz. In appreciation for the fine music the band has provided during today's games, Joe Ock, Assistant Executive Director of the South Dakota High School Activities Association, is now presenting to Buffy Chemnitz, Director of the Ross Holt High School Band, a plaque to commemorate the day. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the award that has become known as the Spirit of Six. The Spirit of Six was created by the South Dakota Peace Officers Association as a memorial for the six cheerleaders from Rapid City who lost their lives in an airplane accident while returning to Rapid City from the 1968 Boys State A Basketball Tournament. As reported by the Rapid City Journal, the spirit epitomized by the Rapid City cheerleaders was best expressed with an inscription on a picture from one of the Rapid City cheerleaders to another member of the squad. The inscription said, "This year has been quite a challenge for everyone. You've got the qualities that a good cheerleader needs. I sure hope that we go to state basketball because that is definitely one of the better sides of cheerleading. Be happy and enjoy the year with all the memories." The award is based upon the cheerleaders' abilities displayed in the areas of crowd control, sportsmanship, enthusiasm, behavior on the court, and dress. Bill Stahl, a past president from the South Dakota Peace Officers Association, is proud to present for the 43rd year the trophy in memory of the six Rapid City cheerleaders to the cheerleaders from Castlewood High School. Mackenzie Olson, Kendra Matt, Brianne Schleisman, Brianna Green, Brianna Davis, Morgan Mack, and Castlewood cheer coach Shannon Bulow. Now, ladies and gentlemen, time for the award of the Spirit of Sioux. The Spirit of Sioux Award was created as a memorial for Sioux Ann Bickrow. She was best known for her accomplishments on the basketball court, but academic achievement and community involvement were equally important to her. The Spirit of Sioux Award is given to an outstanding high school athlete participating at this tournament, who not only shares Sioux Ann's dreams and drive for academic and athletic excellence, but also strives to make life better for others through community service. The player is judged in the categories of outstanding athletic ability, leadership, character, sportsmanship, and GPA. The beautiful colors of the quilt are symbolic of the four races of people. Sioux Ann had a dream that all races could complement each other and live in harmony, thus making the world as beautiful as the quilt we award tonight. Presenting the Spirit of Sioux Award are Kyle Crawford and Detective Tanner Jondahl of the Fraternal Order of Police, and Billy Black from the Visions of Sioux Ann Bickrow Incorporated, along with Erica Shields, a junior from the Aberdeen Central Native American Student Association. This year's Spirit of Sioux Award recipient from Soli Buttes High School, Jordan Lamb.
Williams High School is the winner
and
of the Spirit
once
of
again,
Sioux
the
Award.
Russell.
And the Spirit of Six, the cheerleading award, going to the cheerleaders from Castleward. 28-20, White River has the lead on Viberg-Hurley. We are at halftime and the State Class B Championship game and the boys' basketball tournament here at the Barnett Center in Aberdeen. We'll take this final break, bring you the second half of basketball right after this on member-supported South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Activities Association Championship is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, by Dakota Bank, and by Farmers Union Insurance.
Back at the Barnett Center in Aberdeen, 28-20 the score. White River is leading the Viberg-Hurley Cougars, despite the Cougars shooting 61.5% from the field in the first half. They did not hit a three-pointer, tried one, 4 of 6 from the free throw line. Their leading scorer is Zach Craning with 6 points. Nick Wan has 11 to lead the Tigers. They shoot 41%, 9 of 22, 1 3-pointer in 5 attempts, and 9 of 11 at the free throw line for 81-8. They lead it by 8, and here is the second half as the White River Tigers get the basketball to start the third period. Wyatt Krogman will bring it down as they work left to right on your screen for this final half of Class B boys basketball in the state of South Dakota for the 2011-2012 season. Gilbert Morrison has the ball. Krogman now driving the lane. Shots on the way. Put it up too high and too hard. And the rebound is finally going to come to Morrison. White River gets another chance.
That's one of those 50-50 balls, Gary, that coaches talk about. That could be the difference in this ball game. And White River wanted it a little more than Viberg-Hurley in that instance.
Cougars with the zone, trying to keep Krogman et al. Out of the free throw lane. Left side with it is Gillen. He starts the dribble around the circle. Galen Schoenfeld, as you might have heard, wants the traveling call. Didn't get it. Just underway, third period, 20-20. White River has the lead. Krogman has the ball right side. They try to pass around the zone, break the rhythm. Left side, they go to Morrison. Right-hand dribble, stops in the high left. Coming up on top for Krogman. Wyatt the dribble, switch the hands, look right, come left. Shot, or the ball goes to Morrison. Doesn't shoot. They're going to take their sweet time here. They got the 8-point lead, so they're really not in a hurry to take a shot that might be low percentage. Juan on the high post they come. Here's Gillen. Comes right side once again. That'll be number 23, and that's Nick Juan. Juan leading everybody with 11 points of the contest. Krogman calls out the new play from the head coach of the Tigers, Eldon Marshall, former Todd County Falcon, now coaching at White River. Shots on the way for Krogman. Good, to foul!
Well, he just kept working, spread that defense a little thin. Took Craning out to one side of the zone, and that's opened it up for Krogman to drive the right side.
And really, White River is content to do that all night. When you're up by 10 points, you can go ahead and just stretch the ball, hang on to it as long as you can. Well, Krogman for the three-point play, got it.
You get the lead, you dictate the pace of play, you can dictate a lot of stuff. And I don't know if Viberg-Hurley can get down by more than what they are now at the stage of comeback here against this White River team.
10-point hole to climb out of for the Cougars out of southeast South Dakota, south and west of Sioux Falls, and northwest of the Yankton Vermilion area. Cougar basketball, shot for three on the way off the side of the rim. Ora tries it behind his back. Putback is good, and that'll go to deny.
Wow, Viberg-Hurley crashing the boards, using their size on the inside tonight, coming off the weak side after Hora had missed the reverse layup, but he missed it so badly it had enough of a ricochet on it that let Denai get in there to it.
I can't believe he took that shot. He basically just put up a prayer right over the top of his head, no-look shot. Denai's free throw good.
You know, if he brought it down, somebody who's probably from White River's probably going to take it away from him. That's exactly what Viberg-Hurley needed at that time. Now they need to get a defensive stop.
Cougars cut it to 8. It's 31-23. Denai with 7 points of the game now. Here's Krogman in the lane. One-handers off the side of the rim.
There's the stop.
6'9", Zach Craning coming up with the rebound. And down the floor, Viberg-Hurley comes. Left side with it for a second was Huther. It's knocked out of bounds. Morrison did that. Oh, that'll let Viberg-Hurley regroup.
The quick hands of Gilbert Morrison.
You just don't let your guard down for a second against these guys. They will burn you so bad otherwise.
They're in your face. There's no space between Juan and Jacobson. When you have the ball, they're in your face. And that is what happens. You get an offensive foul. Denied call for the forearm push on Krogman.
That'll be foul number two on Denied. White River is going to take the basketball over. They can make it 10 or 11. And Denied will have his second personal foul. And that's the second team foul of the half, 2.5 minutes in this second half. From the State B Class Championship game, Barnett Center, Aberdeen, South Dakota. Logan Tucker had the ball for a second. They work a double high on the top of the wheel. They will come now for Morrison. Left side is Tucker. He won't take the three. Foul on the push away from the basketball. That is going to go on White River. Viber Curley gets it back. Well, that's one way to get the defensive stop, have him commit a foul. That foul goes on Morrison. He gets it with the push well away from the basketball. He's just trying to set up his position and push the Viber Curley defender out of the way.
Trying to create a little space so he can get the basketball down on the low block so he can post up. Was a little too enthusiastic.
Jacobson comes left side. Denied for three. Fireball! Dennis Denied in and for left side from 21 feet away. It's a 5-point deficit now for the Cougars. It's 31-26. Wyatt Krogman, the junior, as he pointed out to me when I asked him where he's going next year, he simply said White River. And during the practice session on Wednesday, Tucker on top. Top left side, Krogman finds some room in the driveway, shots up, back of the rim, no good. Training the authority rebound. Doesn't have to stretch it a lot at 6'9", but stretch it he did. Shots on the way, Hora good! Flew down the lane on the right side. Andrew Hora put up the shot, it's up, it's good. It's 31-28.
8-0 run by Viber Curley.
Did they need this or what?
Has got him back in the ball game. White River was on the verge of solving this thing away in the third quarter.
Krogman, left side, can't get offensive. The right side. Offensive foul on Krogman. Wyatt's got his third.
Pretty obvious call, and Wyatt knows it. He's not going to argue about it. They call the same thing on Denied on the opposite end. They're not going to let Krogman get away with it on that end.
Logan Tucker sits down. Cody Young is in. Cameron in as well.
That strategy, Gary, that Viber Curley is employing to go underneath the screen is really causing Wyatt Krogman, it's really bothering him.
Denied up top, right side for Hora. Here is Huther on the line, extended right, wants the baseline, can't get it. Over to Denied, good three-point shooter. If he can get it off, it'll come to Huther instead. Quick pass on the left side. Here's Hora, he stops, coming up high for Jacobson. Hora once again, Craning will take the baseline left to right, shots up, he's nailed. Offensive foul is the call on Viber Curley.
Cameron got there. I hope we get a replay on this. You're not going to. Cameron got to the spot, but it wasn't so much where he got. Watch what Craning does here. There's a hand on his back when he turns right there. Cameron beat him to the block, knew right where he was going. Cameron, that's not his man. He came off his man to give a help side defense. That's what White River was not doing in the first half.
3-point lead for the Tigers. It's 31-28. He's struggling on the baseline. Right shots up. He missed it.
How did he get that shot away?
I don't know how he did what he did. And it just rolled off the lip of the rim into the hands of Zach Craning. Craning easily his best game of the weekend for Viber Curley. Denied down in the low block. Wants to back down. Gives it to Hora. Three on the way. Fire the hole. We're tied. 31-31. Hora, the big guy, coming up with the 21-footer up and down. 5 minutes gone, three to play in the third. 31 all tied. Krogman lost control of the dribble. Galen Schoenfeld wants a double dribble call. There's Young for 15, it's no good. Craning tips it back into the hands of Gillen, and it'll stay in the hands of White River. Coleman on the Cameron on the drive. It's up, it's good. The one-hander off the glass and good for Cameron. And that's for Cameron, going to be his first points of the game.
And that stops an 11-0 run for the Cougars.
White River takes the lead at 33-31. Denied from the baseline, left side, shot from 5 of 10.
I didn't think it was possible that a team could reel off 11 straight points against White River.
How in the world they do it? They just made enough halftime adjustments. And they're keeping Krogman, for the most part, out of the lane, too, which is helping immensely, especially Craning with his rebounding. Krogman, 10 feet, left side, good. 35-33, White River.
Too deep, too close for Krogman. Right now at the A, St. Thomas More leading Dakota Valley 44-30. Third quarter score there.
Well on their way to a second consecutive state championship in A. Denied for 15, it's good. Dennis Denied with the hot hand for the Cougars. He ties it up again.
Denied scored 7 of their last 13 points. Denai beginning to feel it here.
Right up at 35. We have flown through quarter number three. Minute 38 to go. Krogman for Cameron left side. Tony Young down low against Kreening. Shots up, rejected. Foul on Zach Kreening.
And showing Coach Schoenfeld for Weiberg Hurley. What you'll see the replay here. Look like from this angle that Young might have lowered the shoulder and initiated the contact. And that's what Weiberg Hurley fans are yelling behind us, Gary, is that he initiated the contact.
Young is at the free throw line regardless. Here's the first for Cody Young. It's good. Man, that didn't want to fall, but it dropped. And here comes the foul.
Right there. The lean-in is what the Weiberg Hurley fans wanted, the little shoulder lean-in.
He did have the shoulder lean. It was dropped. And when they made contact, the foul went on Kreening. 36-35. Young second free throw. Good.
Good ball game.
Very good ball game. Everything you want in a state final. 37-35 our score. Minute 34 to go. And the timeout is called. Galen Schoenfeld talking it over with the Weiberg Hurley Cougars Tigers. And their head coach, Eldon Marshall, discussing some strategy in the final minute 34. White River, I mean, stayed in the game in the first half for a while, but White River was able to bring Weiberg Hurley kind of to their knees toward the end of the half. And then suddenly, Weiberg Hurley comes out like a completely different team in half number two, John.
Closing out the half, well, White River really started this, closed the half well, and then started the second half well. And a lot of coaches point to the first 3 minutes of the quarter, or, you know, the halftime, the end of the half, the halftime to the ball game. See where you're at. How do you close quarters? White River has been very good at closing quarters on a strong surge. The last minute 34 here is going to be very important for Weiberg Hurley to stay in this thing. They don't have the basketball. They trail by two. Scoring leaders so far, Juan and Krogan with 11 for White River, and Denai with 14 to lead all scorers in the ball game for Weiberg Hurley.
And most of those points coming after a very quiet first half.
Gertis in the ball game now for Weiberg Hurley.
Jacobson off the left side. Down low they come. Shot for Denai. No good. He is hammered and fouled. Young will pick that up. Denai to the line.
Well, I told you, before that timeout, Dennis Denai was beginning to feel it. He'd had seven straight points, or had scored seven of the last 13 for Weiberg Hurley. Denai had a set play for him that time on the little break along the baseline. Cody Young coming over to help out. Came off Kreening and picked up the foul. But Cody Young wasn't going to let him go for the three-point play. Made sure that the ball was not going to go through the hoop.
Denai's first free throw is good. 64% foul shooters. There you see the play. There's Denai. And he is just leveled there by Cody Young. And again, the foul on Young. Second shot for Denai. Good. That's his 16th point. It's 37-37. What a wild fourth quarter we're going to have here in Aberdeen. White River, just one loss on the year. They have not lost to a Class B team this season. Their only loss to St. Thomas More. Krogman with the lean-in shot, the one-hander, good, and a foul.
Krogman winds up off the court of play with the contact, but that's what Wyatt Krogman loves. I mean, he really thrives on the contact. He uses the contact to actually create more momentum and more body spin and body turn. And I don't know how he got that shot away. Boy, he really faded.
2-point advantage for White River. Krogman missed the opportunity for the 3-point play. Minute six to go. Galen Schoenfeld calling out the play for the Cougars. Weiberg Hurley hands the ball. Trevor Jacobson working around the horn right side. Number 23, Juan, and number 23, Jacobson. He wants help. Denai's got it on the higher right. Cameron's got him defensively.
They've switched Krogman off Denai and put Cameron on him, a taller player.
Denai on the drive. It's rejected. What a play by Cameron on the block. No foul. Shouldn't have been anyway. The ball will go to White River. Tigers have it with 36 seconds to go.
Hold for one here. Eldon Marshall says, come on, guys, hold for one.
They had the lead of two with 39-37. No reason for the Cougars to come after them just yet. Time a wasting, 23 seconds and counting. White River, as you see, with the lead, 39-32. The score over by Weiberg Hurley. An incredible comeback in this game, though, by the Cougars here in the third period. An 11-0 run, bring them back into it. 8 seconds, 7 seconds. Here's Krogman. You know he wants the shot, and here he goes taking it. He misses everything. It's out of bounds. And with the second and a half left, still waiting to see who gets the ball. It's going to be Vibert Hurley.
I thought that was deflected by the shooter, and that's what Krogman and all of the Wide River fans are saying, that it was deflected. But somebody got a piece of that.
Hora replaces Huether for the final second and a half. We'll see what they can do with it.
1.5. How far up the court will they let them get?
And there is Jacobson with the shot at the buzzer. Missed it.
Just off left.
39-37 the score. White River leading after three. Back in a minute on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Fourth and final quarter getting set to get started. From the Barnett Center, here's Gary with the call.
All right, John, thank you. Didn't we tell each other this was going to be a wild night? Third place game going to Lankford area, close to Vercelli Buttes. He's training with the shot. The one-hander's good.
Well, training at 6'9", Young at 6'5". Craning is going to have the advantage there all the time.
Krogman with the shot underneath. That's not going to go. Rebound is pinballed around. It's out of bounds. Vibert Hurley's got it.
Cody Young in there battling. Got a hand on it to deflect it out of bounds, but Krogman, as soon as the ball went through the net, White River inbounded down the court they went. Didn't give the Vibert Hurley defense a chance to set up.
Just underway, fourth period. Vibert Hurley and White River tied at 39. State Class B title on the line. Denai thinking three, drives the lane, shots on the way, nothing. He missed it, got off the back of the rim, craning with the putback. Nothing called and a foul. He was surrounded by White and none of them fouled him. Krogman on the drive, right side, shots up, no good, foul.
No foul on one end, foul on the other end, and that's what Coach Galen Schoenfeld is going to tell the officials when they come back. But they had all kinds of opportunities to score, did Vibert Hurley. Right there's the body contact, and then the hand on the arm is what they called. That was the foul.
And Hora's the guy who picked up the foul. Krogman at the line, first good, 40-39 White River.
Wyatt Krogman thrives on the contact. He doesn't mind the contact. He likes the contact. He uses that contact to give himself a little more momentum on those spin moves. Coach Schoenfeld for Vibert Hurley told me before the game, he said, you know, we have to keep him out of the lane. He said, the guy's got so much hang time. He can hang in the air and look around and spot people to pass the ball to if he doesn't want to shoot.
That's not easy for a high school junior to do, is it? Jacobson hands the ball left side.
5 second count.
5 second violation is going to be the call on Vibert Hurley. Just a bit of a lapse of concentration combined with good defense by White River. There you see Galen Schoenfeld took the news calmly, so he's not going to argue the call a whole lot.
Crucial point in the ball game right now for Vibert Hurley.
6:53 in the fourth, 41-39. White River the lead, looking to get a championship after being denied in the title game last year by the Jaguars of Corsica Stickney. They're not in the tournament, so we will have a new Class B champion. Krogman looks for some room. Goes left side. Whistle. Traveling violation is the call. That will go against White River. And Vibert Hurley's going to take it back.
Well, and that time they stopped Krogman. Once he got in the paint, they covered him up. Nowhere to go. And they covered up the shooters. That's something that they've kind of been a little lax on at times. They left Juan open in the first half a lot. And he made them pay. But as soon as Krogman stopped, they kept the big guy on him and then covered up the shooters.
Fancy Dan dribble by Jacobson goes off right side. Denai has it on the right off the screen from Craning. Thought about the 15-footer. Get it on top instead. Tyler Gurdish is into the game for Vibert Hurley. Cougars keep the ball. 6:15 to get back into it. Not out of it by any stretch. It's 41-39. Here's Denai. Quick pass to the right. He's fouled.
Well, they had they switched out Cameron, and that's really shut down Denai here after he went off for 7-9 points in a row. They switched Krogman off and took Krogman off Denai and put Cameron on him. And that's bothered Denai.
Gillen with the foul. That's the fifth of the game or of the half for White River. The Tigers one away from the bonus. Right offensive side, Hora, no. Offensive foul goes on the Cougars.
Foul's going to be on Jacobson on the drive. Or excuse me, it's going to be on 1-5 on Denai.
On Denai.
And he had the chance. He had his man beat. He had the chance to pull up a little jump shot. Elected to go one dribble too far.
Denai, Hora, and Craning all the three fouls now for Vibert Hurley. Not a big note now, but as we get later in the game or a possible overtime, That could be a good size factor. Whistle timeout called by Eldon Marshall and the White River Tigers. They lead it here 41-39, but not by any stretch. Is that a safe lead, Jeff? It wouldn't be against anybody, certainly not on a vibrant Hurley squad with a lot of forces inside. So with three fouls on your bigger people, with Kreening with three, and now Hora with three, do you still try to keep it inside, pound it inside, and make sure that you keep Krogman out of the lane on the other end?
Well, the fouls haven't happened on the inside. The fouls have happened on the dribble drive and taking it too deep when they could have pulled up for the little 8-10-foot jump shot. And just taking it too deep, and the White River's been sitting right there waiting on him. So let's see what the strategy is. But now it's up to Coach Schoenfeld, because Eldon Marshall has made his strategy change. He switched Krogman and Cameron. And he's got Cameron on deny. That's kind of shut down the offense. There hasn't been a lot of offense scored this quarter, just both teams with just 2 points each. And a lot of that is because of Cameron on deny. Well, now let's see what Coach Schoenfeld and Vibert Hurley does to counter that.
Tigers basketball. White River has the lead at 41-39. Cougars setting up on the defense now. Jacobson coming up after Krogman a little bit. Got some room to lane if he takes it. Didn't get there. Head to the right side of the circle. Tries the fancy dribble. Off right side. Juan's got it. And here's Krogman toward the center circle. Working toward the right side. Comes off the screen toward the corner. Works the baseline. It gets stuck on the baseline. Get it back over to Juan. Trying to make the Cougars come after them here. Top left side of the circle. Cameron's into the game. Krogman has it in the center circle. Jacobson has him defensively for the Cougars. 5:17 to go, third quarter, 41-39, White River the lead. Left side is Cameron, back over on the right. Here comes Juan, wants to drive, Curtis stops it. Get it over to Krogman. Wyatt sets a left-hand dribble, traveling violation. No, it's a foul on the hand check. It goes on the Cougars. That'll be Jacobson who'll get it, and there's another Vibert Hurley player with three fouls. Four players on the floor, but three fouls now for Vibert Hurley. I really thought Wyatt Krogman was going to get it for traveling, and Vibert Hurley would get the ball back. But that is going to put Wyatt Krogman to the line on the foul.
Well, Coach Marshall has shown his hand here. Expect White River to spread the floor. Look for the dribble penetration from Krogman and kicking it out. Of course, there's Wyatt's older brother, Louie, looking on.
Right there in the front row. Second shot is on the way, out the back of the rim. He missed it.
Big rebound.
Young got the rebound. White River regroups. 42-39 lead. 1-1 on the free throws. Hit the first, missed the second, but the Cougars had the lead. And the ball. Gillen had it right side. Gets it off to Krogman. Jacobson with the unenviable task of guarding him. Here is Krogman with the drive. They just gave him the lane, and he put it up and in again, John.
Gave him the lane, but also Krogman fading away when he saw Kreening come. I don't know how he did that in midair, Gary. I'm just stunned.
Denai coming on the drive. Big crowd around him. He's fouled, and he will go to the line for a couple.
Well, it's back to 5 points right now. And getting close to that point in the ballgame where Eldon Marshall is going to pull it out and say, come on, you come out here and get us or you foul us.
Denai inbounds, 44-39 White River, 4:29 in period number four. And with the ball is White River.
Denai trying to throw it in. He had a man that was curling around on the block wide open, but it went off one of the White River kids' heads. I think it's Gillen. I think it went off his head.
And whistle foul on the hand check. That's going to go on Denai. That'll be number four. That is the last thing Denai Schoenfeld or the Vibert Hurley Cougars need at this point. But Dennis Denai is going to get his fourth. He has played his heart out and had an incredible second half, John.
Well, Denai's been your offense in this half, Gary, to be honest with you. And if he's not on the floor, nobody else from Vibert Hurley's really stepped up. Jacobson will be your next option. Jacobson shooting about 40% for threes on the season, but has not had a good look at it with Juan covering him up.
Jacobson on Juan right now. He's on the high right. Get it off on the right side. Line extended. Denai is there. Training on the high post. Working against Cody Young. Left side they go. Gertis has the ball. He's all tied up. Want to set it up on the down low. There's the shot. There's a foul. We're coming the other way? No.
Jacobson shooting three throws here. Nice little pump fake. Got the defender in the air.
Gillen got the foul. That for Gillen is going to be number five.
Gillen is done.
That was a sneaky five fouls on Gillen.
Wow. 52-43, St. Thomas More leading Dakota Valley with 3:56 to play in the game there at the state A championship.
I would think the AA final, Mitchell and Sioux Falls of Gorman would be starting fairly soon. First for Jacobson is good. 44-40, 3:50 to go. Second shot is on the way for Jacobson. He got that one. Jacobson with his fifth point. It is 44-41 White River. 3 minutes and 43 to go. Krogren with a nice behind-the-back dribble. Lost control. Gets it out to Cameron. That was a nice pass to save the offensive possession that time. Cameron the ball on high left. Coming to Krogren. He wants some room. He's got some room. He's on the drive. Shots on the way. Front of the rim and no good. Burbank had it in his hands. Lost it. It goes into the hands of Ryan Klute for Viburg Hurley.
Let's see if they set up a three-point shot to go for the tie or work for the...
Well, we're going to find out in a couple of minutes after Galen Schoenfeld gets done talking with his team on this timeout. 3 minutes and 16 to go. Everything you could want in a Class B championship game. Really a championship game at every level. Any level, he means. You've got it right here. They're going to bring Denai in for the final 3:16. That would tend to tell you, John, that they want to go for three here.
Well, you would think they might run that. 20 turnovers on the night for Viburg Hurley. 20 turnovers, only seven for White River.
Here comes Krogman down the lane. Last time around, beautiful move inside. Just hung in the air. Got the hands around. There aren't a lot of guys at the high school level. Maybe there aren't a lot of guys in basketball who can do that.
Viburg Hurley on the game shooting 60%. They're 15 of 25. White River at 40%, 14 of 35. On threes tonight, White River only 16%. They're 1 of 6 on threes. And as far as rebounds, Viburg Hurley out-rebounding White River 23 to 13. Krogman with 18, Juan with 11, all coming in the first half. And Denai with 16 to lead the way for Viburg Hurley.
Denai into the game. Keep in mind, he's got four fouls. Training is back at the contest as well. Andrew Hora will inbound to somebody. And finally, that is going to go to Trevor Jacobson. Jacobson works on Juan. That's been an epic battle today. Here's the shot right side. Nope, it goes out of bounds off Curtis. Galen Schoenfeld wants the foul. It doesn't happen. And Tavis Burbank is going to inbound for White River.
Well, they had their chance.
It was there. They tried to put the shot up, but went out of bounds off the Cougars.
And that was their 21st turnover of the ball game.
Juan on the high right. Switch hands of the dribble. Coming top of the circle. Inside the center circle, Dallas Krogman. He's got the ball running the offense for Eldon Marshall's White River Tigers. 2 minutes 45 away from a state title. But it's only a three-point lead and not at all comfortable. Cameron on the drive in the lane right side. Has Burbank there off the screen. Coming down the lane now is Cameron. Quick pass right side and a traveling violation is going to be the call at White River. Wanted to set up the pass to Burbank but traveled before he could do it. Viburg Hurley will get it back. They can cut it to two or they can tie it. 2.5 minutes to go, fourth quarter. Overtime, a distinct possibility, but let's get through regulation first. Hora has it high post, off right side. Here's Denai, wants to shoot. He is hit, little bit of body contact. Nothing called, White River's got the ball.
Viburg Hurley fans wanting a foul, but a good no call. Instead of bailing out the offensive player, felt the contact. He was losing control of the basketball, Gary. So he just kind of launched himself up for the shot here.
Krogman, big crowd, rejected by Kreening. Zach got a hand on the ball and just as quickly lost it. Krogman's got it. White River keeps it. Krogman with a quick pass right side, left side Burbank. He is nailed and fouled on Hora.
Somebody, I hope that somebody has this on film and shows this to young post players everywhere and tell them, do not bring the ball below your shoulders. Some of those little guards will seal it every time. Just happened to Kreening. Brought the ball down. Krogman had missed the shot. They had him stop. And Krogman never gave up on the play. Came out and just ripped it right out of his hands.
Tavis Burbank makes it a four-point game with the first successful free throw. 45-41 is the score. Minute 53 to go. Burbank gets another. It's on the way and he got it. Tavis Burbank with his first 2 points of the game. Timeout called by White River with a minute 53 to go. Okay, you're Gavin Schoenfeld. You've got 5 points to make up in a minute 53, and you got a lot of people in foul trouble. What's the strategy here?
Don't turn it over. They've turned the ball over 21 times tonight. They were trying to work for the tying shot just two possessions ago and turned it over. They have to cut down the turnovers for the last 2 minutes if they have any chance at all in this game.
It has been a long and checkered last few years for Vibrant Hurley basketball. In 2011, the Class A runners-up as they fall to St. Thomas More in the finals in Rapid City. 2010, they're in the B tournament here, lost to White River 65-59. And in 2009, they were at Vibrant High School. They finished in fifth place in the B tournament. Their championship dream ended courtesy Sully Butte, 65-62. Here we go, minute 50 to go, 5-point lead for White River, it's 46-41. Jacobson works on one, right side, stop line extended, bounce pass at the top of the circle for Denai. Working off the screen for training, Denai left side, thinking about the three, he'll drive instead, shots up, nothing doing, foul on the hand check is going on Cameron.
Cameron on the hole, they're going to get him, and for some reason they got switched back, and Krogman picked up Denai that time, and Denai recognized it, took him right to the basket. And Cameron coming over to help out, committed the foul.
Matt Jensen is coming in for Vibert Hurley as soon as he gets an opportunity. Ryan Klute will check in too. Klute will come in now. He's replacing Craning. Probably a little more mobile than Zach Craning at this point, John, although you're giving up some height. And coming in for the shooter will be Jensen. Denai's free throw is good. It's 46-42. He'll get another.
We'll probably see the offense for defense switch here with Vibert Hurley with Denai.
Second one on the way, rolls around, got it.
It's back to three.
Dramatic free throw makes it a 3-point ball game. Denai with 18 points and 4 fouls. Minute 37 to go. Denai will sit down, join the rest of his Vibert Hurley teammates. And Jensen is into the game, the 5'9 freshman. Racehorsing it down is Krogman right side. Just won the beat. Shots on the way, he got it. No doubt in anyone's mind what Wyatt Krogman was going to do on that play, and he did it. 48-43, timeout, Vibert Hurley. That leaves him with one left.
Vibert Hurley went to sleep after they on the free throw. And once Wyatt Krogman, they were running the press, and they had their two big guys back at half court. Once Wyatt caught the inbound pass, turned and looked up, saw the big guys. No, you're not going to stop him.
Just ran right past Andrew Hora. Here he comes. Just had the one guy to beat, and Ryan Klute wasn't able to do too terribly much there, because if he fouls, he gets a foul on the block. Krogman probably hits that shot, and you're looking at a 3-point play, and you're really in a deep hole now. As it stands, it's 5 points at 48-43 with a minute 24 to left. You can see the emotions in this Barnett Center gym.
Well, doesn't matter if you're a Vibert Hurley fan or a White River fan, you have to appreciate what Wyatt Krogman brings to the game of basketball. As a basketball fan, I'm sitting here just amazed, and I keep telling myself this is a team that I would pay to go see. That's it. I mean, it's just amazing to watch the way they flow together. When they see the opportunity to score or to take it, they take it.
And this program is just a machine in the southwestern part of South Dakota, playing in its fifth straight Class B title game. Didn't win it last year. Corsica Stickney, the defending B champions, but again, not here. Denai on top. Minute 14 to go. Wants the lane. Krogman stops him. Turns and fires. It's on the way up the front of the rim. Galen Schoenfeld wants the call of a foul. It doesn't happen. Here comes Krogman again. He's down the lane. It fires. It's no good. And the foul is going to come on the other end. I think that's on training. That'd be four. Three-two. We'll pick it up. Craning on the push, fourth personal foul for Zach Craning. Wyatt Krogman again at the free throw line. All he's done is scored 20 points tonight. First shot is on the way, good. And here is the drive by Krogman. He gets around Hora, and there is the foul as Craning gets him on the body. And a good call against Zach Craning. He did get the foul, it's his fourth. Krogman's free throw missed. 49-43 with a minute to go. Cougars with some work to do, a long way to go, and a short time to get there. Jacobson off the screen, wants the three-pointer. Krogman's got it, not Krogman, rather, Craning. He had it in the corner, it's knocked out of bounds, and it will go back to Viper Curley.
White River knows that they need threes or two. It's a two-possession ball game, and they're challenging everything around the three-point line. See if Viper Curley changes the outlook and goes for the quick two.
Jacobson, three ball on the way. It's in and out, no good. Burbank the rebound. Tavis Burbank came up with the rebound. Viper Curley wanted done off the trap, and a foul will go on Craning. And that'll be it for Zach Craning. Craning calls it a career at Byron Hurley High School. He's had a tough tournament, scoring in the single digits the whole time. Had 6 points in the first game, two on Friday against Woolsey Wessington, and now leaves with 8 points. First shot is on the way. Nick Juan got it. You don't want it. He's a very good free throw shooter. 86% from the line for the year. 50-43. Second one is on the way. It's now an 8-point game. And I think White River can start celebrating. 41.9 seconds to go. An 8-point lead for the White River Tigers. And another championship coming to the White River squad. They can hang on for 42 more seconds, John. We'll have the all-tournament team coming up after the game is over. We'll also bring you the presentation of the trophies to the state runner-up and to the state champion.
Well, it looks like we will have a back-to-back champion in Class A, St. Thomas More, with 9 seconds left, leading Dakota Valley 63-54. And how close did St. Thomas More come to going down in the opening day? Only to survive, to move on.
White River, state champion in 2008, runner-up in 2009, state champion in 2010, runner-up in 2011. The even-numbered years have been kind to the White River squad, and it looks like that pattern will continue. Byron Hurley will inbound. Andrew Hora will take the honor. Jacobson brings it down. He's across the line. Cougars, a lot of work to do in a short time. Hora's got it high post. Left side to come deny. He'll stop and fire the three. It's too hard. It's too long, and Juan gets the rebound. Against the trap, they'll get it to Krogman. Long pass is down the floor, but a foul is called, and Krogman's going to go to the line for two. Foul will go on Viper Hurley. That will be on Ryan Klute of the Cougars. They are starting to feel it in the White River cheering section. ...51-43 is the score, 25.4 seconds left. Krogman's first, good. White River has been in a battle though, as Viper Hurley down 8 at halftime, making some really good adjustments and coming up with an 11-0 run to get back into it. Krogman misses the second free throw. 21 seconds, 20, 52-43 the score. Here's Jacobson, he lost the ball. Here comes Juan on the drive, just one to beat. He's just gonna set it up. Racehorse it around for the final 14 seconds. They are feeling it now. 8 seconds, 7 seconds. Krogman backpedaling, hanging onto the basketball with two, with one. It's over, White River's your champion. Start the party in White River. The Tigers win the State B title.
52-43 will be your final, and it is just gone final in Sioux Falls. 63-56. St. Thomas More, congratulations to the Cavaliers winning back-to-back State A championships with a 63-56 final over Dakota Valley. Here it was White River defeating Viberg Hurley 52-43. White River led by Wyatt Krogman with 22 points. Nick Juan with 13. It was Dennis Denai with 18 to lead the way for Viberg Hurley. Denai, the only player in double figures for White River or for Viberg Hurley. And Gary Ellenbold has the victorious Eldon Marshall courtside. Gary, take it away.
Thank you very much, John Sieber. Coach Eldon Marshall is here. They complete a 25-1 season and get the state Class B championship as the number one seed. Anything but easy tonight, Coach, though.
Definitely not. It was a Viberg Hurley is a great team. They're well coached, very disciplined, and we knew it'd be tough coming in, but our kids are tough also, and they did what we needed to down the stretch. We didn't play our best, but I thought we did what we needed to do, and gotta credit our kids. Our kids are awesome, and I can't say enough about how proud I am of them.
One thing that a lot of coaches told me throughout the weekend, the secret to stopping White River is keeping Wyatt Krogman out of the free throw lane. And Viberg Hurley, when they didn't do that, really got burned because Krogman can hang in the air forever, it seems, and he has so many people that he can dish off to that can really hurt an opponent. Really a great team effort there, especially when Krogman can get in the lane and have so many options.
Well, if we can get the lead toward the end in the fourth quarter, we can spread him out, and that allows Wyatt to get in the lane because he can go by anybody, I think. He's just a great ball handler, great leader, great all-around kid, just like the rest of our kids. It's a great team effort, especially on the defensive end.
And when you take a look, Krogman, he ends the day with 22 points. Nick Wan with another classic Nick Wan game. He not only had some tough defending to do against Jacobson, but got you a bunch of points as well.
Definitely. He's just another great all-around kid, and he's a great ball player for us. He's worked so hard in the offseason and during the year, and I couldn't be more proud. And I wanted it for those guys more than, anything. That's what I'm – all of the guys. They're just a great team, great bunch to be around, and they're going to be back next year.
Now, Viberg Hurley had an 11-0 run to start the third period. They'd made some pretty good adjustments at halftime. What's going through your mind at that point?
Just to stick with it. Try and persist. Rely on our defense again. They're still getting some scores out of there, but, we're able to get some scores offensively also, get to the free throw line. Now, Tavis came in, hit a couple big free throws for us down the stretch, and, boy, it was huge.
A beautiful win, Coach. Congratulations.
Thank you.
State Class B champion White River Tigers. We'll take a break and come back with our award ceremony from the Barnett Center in Aberdeen on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this.
Is Board of Directors member Gene Brownell. Assisting with the awards and representing the association's corporate partners are Gordon Larson of Sanford Health, Christy Osterloo of First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Terry Lindy of Farmers Union Insurance, and Sergeant First Class Aaron Wahlberg of the South Dakota Army National Guard. This year's runner-up of the 2012 State B Basketball Tournament are the Cougars of Viberg Hurley. Clay Jurgensen, Tyler Novak, Tyler Gerdes, Colin Sherrod, Dennis Denai, Matt Jensen, Austin Bierkus, Jack Huther, Trevor Jacobson, Braden Myers, Ryan Clute, Andrew Hora, Seth Anderson, and Zach Craning. Team statisticians, Damaris Houtcooper. Managers, Ty Gergen, Milan Jacobson, Cody Overgaard, and Lane Kropinski. Assistant coaches, Tony Hauger, Justin Oswald, and the head coach for the Viberg Hurley Cougars, Galen Schoenfeld. The Viberg Hurley Welcome Home Celebration will take place at the Viberg Gym Sunday at 4:30. And now for your 2012 State B champions, the White River Tigers. Link Tucker. Gilbert Morrison. Joe Cameron. Corey Rogers. Tavis Burbank. Trey Ayat. Nick Wan. Benson Charging Hawk. Wyatt Krogman. Cody Young. Bubba Young. Justin Prue. Logan Tucker. Matthew Gillen. And Justin Folkers. Team statisticians, Ashlyn Plooster. Gabby Wan. Managers, Chris Eaglebear. Dylan Marshall. Nicholas Marshall. Gunner Piper. And Nicholas Young. Assistant coach, Jared Bauman. And the head coach for the 2012 State Class B champions, Eldon Marshall. We'd like to once again direct your attention to the center of the court for the presentation of the All-Tournament Team Awards. The All-Tournament Team is selected by the South Dakota High School Basketball Coaches Association. As the name of the All-Tournament Team members are announced, each recipient should come to the award area to pick up their plaque. This year's All-Tournament Team members are Nate Widow of Dupree, Jordan Fireisen of Castlewood, Jordan Marquardt of Hanson, Jacob Barcher of Hanson, Connor Euler of Sully Buttes, Jordan Lamb of Sully Buttes, Kyle Johnson of Lankford, Nick Alberts of Langford. From Viborg Hurley, Trevor Jacobson. From Viborg Hurley, Dennis Denai. From White River, Nick Wan. And from White River, Wyatt Krogman. Your 2012 Class B All-Tournament Team. You may now come on the floor.
Congratulations to the White River Tigers, 52-43 winners over Viborg Hurley tonight for the State B Championship game. We'll come back with player interviews and final stats in just a few minutes right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Activities Association Championship is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, by Dakota Bank, and by Farmers Union Insurance.
Well, we are back here live at the Barnett Center in Aberdeen, joined by a couple of victorious Tigers here this evening, Wyatt Krogman and Nick Wan. Guys, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
A little tougher game than maybe you thought coming in. You beat this team by 20 the regular season, but they kind of changed things up on you defensively, didn't they?
Well, I mean, when we beat them, they did have a few guys out. You know, Jacobson was out, and Kranning only played a half. And those two are the two of their big guns. And they came in, and we knew it was going to be a dogfight right from the start. And it played up to that bill. It was a perfect state championship game. It always comes down to defense and free throws, and we were able to win those areas in the end. And I'm just so proud of our guys. All of them played amazing.
Sound like you were going to go into coaching, Nick, after that defensive free throws thing. You guys must get that preached at you a lot in practice, huh?
Every day, Elvin tells us that's where it's always going to come down to. Towards the beginning of the year, we had some kind of blowout wins, but we always knew when we got here that's what it was going to be. It was a defense and free throws, and we were able to pull it off just like he'd always hoped we would.
Did you guys feel any pressure at all? We talked to Eldon about this. We asked Eldon about the pressure to win it. Everybody said it was White River's tournament to lose. And we asked Eldon, no, there's no pressure. But did you guys feel any pressure at all during the season?
You know, of course there's pressure being number one, but, you know, that's good pressure. You want that. You want to be number one. Just like Nick said, that's what it comes down to, defense and free throws. But, I think there's always pressure when you're number one. But I like it. I like it. I like it.
Just watching you guys the last couple of years, seems like that you really thrive on the pressure and on the competition level of things.
Definitely. We improved from last year, you know, in the championship game. We were kind of herky-jerky. We weren't sure what's going on. But, you know, we improved, we matured, and we got a lot better. And now, you know, that's what happens.
I noticed that in the first couple of games that last year when I covered you guys here at the State B's, Wyatt, and it seemed like you were doing a lot more on the offensive side of the basketball, a lot more driving, a lot more of the shooting. This year, the first couple of games, and even tonight, you don't have to do that anymore, do you? I mean, you've got some great teammates around you.
Yeah, for sure. These guys have really stepped up this tournament. And, you know, the defenses are different this year. They're kind of adjusting, and these guys are stepping in right into their roles, and they're doing a great job of it. I love them so much.
The one play that I saw tonight that I just had to shake my head and go, wow, was on the dribble penetration from the corner. When you came into the lane, Kranning had you stopped. Here was Nick sliding down on the wing over here, and you didn't even have to look. You just, boom, toss it out. You knew he was going to be waiting there, drain the three.
We get that. We have a sixth sense out on the court. We've been playing with each other for so long, and I know where he's going to be on that drive, and I know when he's going to throw that ball, and he knows exactly where I'm going to be. And that's just, we could do that one with our eyes closed. We do that all the time in practice and open gyms. That was just a perfect play for us.
All our lives, man.
That's our play. That's where we're always in. Last year in the state tournament, you talked about how Wyatt did all the scoring, and going into the offseason, we knew that we had to help Wyatt, you know. I mean, we knew he was our leader, but we had to help him some way, somehow, and I think we did that. I think we stepped up big this year and helped him out, and, of course, he came up big again in the championship game like we knew he would.
Game of horse between you two. Who wins?
I'm going to take Nick. because he can make a jump shot every now and then.
I don't know if it got into some crafty layups. I take him all day, all day.
Guys, congratulations on the state championship, and I hope to see you guys back here again next year.
Yep, thank you so much.
Enjoy this with your fans and with your families. Thanks, guys. We're back to the Barnett Center in Aberdeen right after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
We have a new Class B champion for the third time in 6 years. The White River Tigers come up with the decision, winning in even-numbered years, 2012, 2010, and 2008, and then losing the 2009 and 2011 championship games. I think it's safe to say there's a dynasty in southwestern South Dakota. White River gets the decision, 52-43 over Vyburg Hurley. Anything but easy, as Eldon Marshall said, but the Tigers do come up as the number one seed, beat the number three seed of the championship game. 52-43 was the final score, as White River ends the game shooting 40.5%. They go 15 of 37 for the game, 1 of 6 in three-point territory, and then 21 of 28 at the free throw line. That's 75%. Their leading scorer, Wyatt Krogman, 22 points, 6 of 18 shooting, 3 of 10. Actually, 10 of 15, I should say, from the free throw line. 13 points for Nick Wan.
Well, let's look at some highlights while we look at the rest of the stats here for you. Highlights from the State B championship game, won by White River, and it was a battle. They got up by 11 points in the second half, third quarter there. Looked like they were ready to put this thing away. And Dennis Denai loaded the Vyburg Hurley team on his back. They went on an 11-0 run to tie it up. And when it came down to the crunch time, it was Wyatt Krogman, and Eldon Marshall said it, Nick Wan said it. When it comes to those off-the-wall layups and body-twisting layups, he'll take his teammate Wyatt Krogman every time, whether it's a game of horse or a game of basketball. White River spread the floor, and Wyatt went to work and secured it. Eldon Marshall now 3-2 in the state championship games, Gary.
And that's in the last five championship games in Class B. Vyburg Hurley has played in two straight championship games, losing in Class A to St. Thomas More, who won the A championship tonight, by the way, over Dakota Valley, and now falling in the B championship game against White River. Again, that final 52-43.
And Dennis Denai leading the way for Vyburg Hurley tonight with 18 points. 9 points for Andrew Hora, 8 points for Zach Craning, and 5 points for Trevor Jacobson tonight. And for Vyburg Hurley, shooting 51% from the field, 15 of 29, and 11 of 13 at the free throw line. Great effort by Coach Galen and his team, but coming up just a little bit short tonight against the very tough White River team.
Your third place winner was the Langford Area Lions, as they get the win over Sully Buttes in the third place contest. Fifth place is going to the just get a look and we'll be factual
Hanson.
About this here. Hanson is the winner in fifth place as they took care of Castlewood. 50-31 was that final score, and we started the day 57-52, Dupree defeating Woolsey Wessington for seventh. So eighth goes to the Woolsey Wessington Warbirds, Dupree in seventh, Castlewood sixth, Hanson number five, Sully Buttes in fourth place, Langford with the three-point win. They had a fascinating weekend, and Langford finishes third, Vyburg Hurley second, and your state Class B champion, White River. Castlewood wins the Spirit of Sioux Award in the cheerleading division, and the Spirit of Sioux goes to Jordan Lamb of Sully Buttes, John.
Indeed, and I think we're about to wrap this to wrap up our coverage here of the State Bees for this year, and I certainly want to thank you, everybody involved with South Dakota Public Broadcasting for having me on board for this. I've had a great time. Fantastic tournaments the last couple of weeks we've been to.
Indeed it was. Wouldn't have done it without you, partner. Thanks.
Best crews ever in the world that I've ever worked with when it comes to the broadcasting side of things.
See you again in 2013. Let's get it done. And let's congratulate and thank our camera operators, folks behind the scenes from the Aberdeen area who just did a magnificent job. I mean, you guys were total pros. And if that's the route you take in your careers, you are headed for good ones. It was just a beautiful weekend on the cameras. Thanks to them. Thanks to Steve Bunsen, Eka John, also Chad Anderson. for their work back behind the scenes. Larry Rohrer, our director of content. And we will ramp up with those notes. The Class B State Boys Tournament. White River is your state champion with a 52-43 win over Viber Curley. The executive director of South Dakota Public Broadcasting is Julie Anderson. Larry Rohrer, our director of content. Bob Bussey, our director of television. For everybody in Aberdeen and for everybody along the tournament trail, and especially for John Siever, I'm Gary Ellenbolt. Good night from Aberdeen, everyone. You've been listening and watching the South Dakota High School Activities Association Class B State Boys Basketball Tournament, a copyright production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Good night.